In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create smart chips to preview links in Google Docs for third-party services using Google Apps Script. Hi, I'm Chanel, a developer advocate at Google. Follow along as we build smart chips to preview links from Google Books. For users to preview links from a third-party service in Google Docs, we create a Google Workspace add-on. We configure the add-on to preview URL patterns so that when users type or paste such a URL into a document, Google Docs prompts them to replace the link with a smart chip. The smart chip displays an icon and short title or description of the link's content. When the user hovers over the smart chip, they see a card interface that previews more information about the file or link. To create a Google Workspace add-on, you need a Google Workspace account and access to the Google Cloud Console. We have created a new standalone Google Apps Script project in which we will configure our link previews. In the project settings, we tick the box so that the manifest file is shown in the editor. Once in the appscript.json file, we add two scopes to the OAuth scope section. The workspace.linkpreview scope is used so that the users can authorize the add-on to preview links on their behalf. The script.externalRequest scope is for our script to make a request with the URL fetch app service to the Google Books API. We also add an add-on section and some information like the name and icon for our add-on. In the doc section, we implement the link preview triggers that includes a run function, which we will define later on in the code.js file. Within the trigger section, we configure the URL patterns for which we want our smart chip to preview links for. Whenever a link matches one of the URL patterns in a Google Docs document, the callback function booklinkpreview builds and displays a smart chip and card. In our code.js file, we write the getBook function to make a call to the Google Books API using the URL fetch app service. As you can see, we need an API key, and you will learn later on in this video where you can generate this key. To return a smart chip and card for a link, we implement the booklinkpreview function that we specified in the linkpreviewTriggers object in the manifest file. We define our callback function to accept an event object containing docs.matchURL.url as an argument and return a single card object. We extract the relevant information we get from the Google Books API to display it in the smart chip and card. Using AppScript's card service, we create the UI of the card that will be displayed when a user hovers over the smart chip. For our add-on, we will be using the decorated text, image, text button, and divider widgets. Check the developer documentation to learn more about the supported components for preview cards. Once we have defined all the widgets, it's time to put them together by using the addWidget method to add every element to the card. The return statement is what finally builds the card. As previously mentioned, our function can only return one card. In the Google Cloud Console, we have created a new project for our add-on. In the APIs and Services section, we configure the OAuth consent screen, which will be shown to the users the first time they use the add-on. We will configure our add-on to be of type internal, and hence the adding of scopes is not necessary. Under Credentials, plus Create Credentials, we select API key and copy the key. Back in the AppScript IDE, we add the API key, which we generated. We will use the search functionality in the Google Cloud Console to find and enable the Books API. In the project settings, we find the project number, which we copy. In the AppScript IDE, in the project settings, we replace the default GCP project with the one we have created. To test our add-on, we select Test Deployments under Deploy. In this interface, we install our Google Workspace add-on and are now ready to try it out. In Google Docs, paste the link of a book found in Google Books. Since we are using our add-on for the first time, we have to grant it permission to run. The smart chip appears, and when we hover over it, the card is displayed. At the bottom is a button, which, when clicked, leads to the corresponding book in Google Books. In this video, you learned how you can create smart chips to preview links in Google Docs using AppScript. Check out the developer documentation to see how you can create such an add-on using an alternate runtime. Leave us a like if you've learned something new in this video, and subscribe to this YouTube channel to learn more about developing on the Google Workspace platform.